This is dedicated to the homies that was down since day one. Welcome to Drop D.
The following was recorded and produced for Drop D Podcast Productions by Grant Wilson.
Drop D Productions, this is Rob. How may I help you?
Yes, is this Raymond Clark?
No, it's Rob Clark.
Yeah, we're just calling Jedediah Exabibande from Our Lady of the Blessed Copperhead. What are you fellas, Dean or Dexter?
It's Doug, yeah.
Total joke on your podcast, and you're hated both myself and Yahweh. What about this? I came home one day carrying a duck in his left arm. He was in the kitchen where his wife was preparing dinner. She turned around and he said, "This is the pig I've been fucking." She looks at the duck, looks back at him, and says, "That's a duck." He said, "I was talking to the duck."
Oh, shit. I went to the doctor and I got some medicine that kind of preempted it. I mean, I felt it coming.
Yeah.
So I nipped it in the bud real quick.
Dude, last year, New Year's Eve, we're at my mother-in-law's eating dinner because we always kind of go over there and she does the whole appetizer finger food thing, you know. We always end up over there on New Year's Eve. And my youngest son was eating, sitting at the couch watching TV, dude, and he leapt up. Ran upstairs, blah, and that was the onset of the flu last year. And by New Year's Eve, by January 2nd, I was down. I was down with it bad.
Damn.
This year, dude, it was a 12-hour time differential. We went over to my mother-in-law's house and did our thing. Went home. The next morning, New Year's Day, he woke up sick as hell. And it was the same cycle. And him and I got just sicker than dogs. But we didn't get a flu shot this year. My wife and my other son did. They did not get sick. But it was pretty crappy.
Yeah. Are we recording yet? Or what the hell?
Oh, yeah. We've been
recording. Oh, we are?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, maybe. Just maybe, Doug. a retiring high school teacher.
I was not there. You were about to say, maybe, Doug, you'll fucking tell me next time. I guess I assume that you saw the thumbs up from Grant, too. I don't know why.
No, I don't know.
Okay. I apologize, my friend.
That's okay, because we're right into it, buddy. We're right into it.
All right. Yeah, I'm settling in now, man.
Speaking of having to run to the bathroom, okay?
Speaking of having to run to the bathroom.
A retiring high school teacher who I'm guessing probably was forced to retire after this incident admits to defecating in a Wisconsin public park several times a day for 2 years straight. And this son of a bitch looks as happy as can be.
Is I don't even know where to begin to ask questions. I just want to hear the story.
All right. Jeffrey Churchwell.
Surely to God, we get a little insight as to motive into what this dude's thinking.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. He admitted to defecating outside of and on top of a building at Nature Park in the town of Whitewater, sometimes several times a day since 2017. He told authorities he did it for convenience and to purposely be disrespectful.
To purposely be convenience. So yeah. The toilet in his house wasn't convenient.
Well, no, he would leave school and go shit in this park.
So they don't have bathrooms at the school?
I don't know. He probably has some kind of weird, sick fetish.
Oh, man.
He's obviously a Green Bay Packers fan.
Obviously. So what subject did he teach? Does it say?
I'm not sure. Let's get through it here.
All right.
It says Churchwell has to pay $365 in fines. That's it?
That's a dollar a day per poop.
Plus, He has to pay $5,700 in restitution to the public works department that had to clean up after him. Authorities caught him in October last year when a deputy spotted Churchwell's vehicle, stopped him as he drove into the park. Earlier that day, sheriff's deputies had already spoken to a worker at the Walworth County Highway Shop who complained about someone defecating on a park building and leaving used toilet paper behind.
Oh, well, at least he was, you know, practicing good hygiene while he was pooping.
Yeah, he must have had a roll with him, you know.
Well, yeah, obviously. That's good, you know. He would have been easy to spot doing that fucking duck walk back to the school. You know, they would have, oh, it's that guy. He's the one shitting everywhere.
The worker showed deputies photos from trail cameras that showed the man defecating in the park. The pictures also showed Churchwell's car parked nearby and a partial plate number, which was used to identify the teacher.
That's some pretty good detective work.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
When the deputy pulled him over, driving into the park, he initially said he didn't know why he was being stopped. And deputies asked if it would be helpful if they had photos of him doing anything. And Churchwell hung his head and admitted to going to the bathroom in the park. Asked what he meant and if it was in a park bathroom, Churchwell reportedly responded, "A number two." Without a bathroom. He also acknowledged he occasionally defecated in the park on the way to school. A day after his arrest, Churchwell wrote to the sheriff's deputy who stopped him and apologized and said he realizes that he made a mistake.
Aw, he's humble and contrite. I'm sorry, so, I pooped.
I'm so disappointed in myself. I have the great opportunity to teach political rhetoric. In this class, I stress the importance of involved citizenship. And then there I am being a lousy citizen of Walworth County.
Wait a minute. I'm savoring the irony of someone who is an expert in political rhetoric leaving piles of shit everywhere.
Yes.
There is a symbolism in that, Rob.
There is.
There is. It seems aptly fitting. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Political rhetoric, piles of shit. It's basically the same thing.
It is.
Yeah.
He closes the letter with, "as well, after really," and that's in all capitals, "really thinking about why I did what I did, I came to the conclusion that I allowed my thrill-seeking, self-indulgent pride and ego both get the best of me."
Nah, he's full of
shit.
I
don't know what I was thinking. So there you go.
I think he's full of
random pooper.
I think he's full of shit. That's all I can say about that guy.
He must be. He must be. Shit very frequently.
You know, it's ironic. It's ironic, Rob, that you bring up old people, retired people doing weird things in a park.
Oh, pray tell.
Because this story that I had that I literally saved, I actually had this for the last episode of BTFU, but we never got to it. But ironically enough, it's kind of the same thing. Get this. This is Dateline. This is from November, all right, Connecticut. This is from Meredith News Service, so you know it's real. Check this out. Six Connecticut seniors were arrested after police say they caught the group allegedly having a sex orgy in a public park.
I'm in so far.
He's speechless somewhere. According to the Associated Press, the ages of the arrested seniors range between 62 and 85. Police in Fairfield, Connecticut said the spot the seniors were caught in was advertised in a city hookup guide as a place for strangers to meet up and have sex. The officers set up surveillance in the area, which is how they caught the seniors and several other people. The group of six seniors consisted of five men and one 85-year-old woman, Rob.
Wow.
Wow.
Wow. How many men?
Five men and one 85-year-old woman. The ranges, it says the age ranges for the participants was 62, between 62 and 85. So that tells me that this lady was
an old professional.
She was the oldest of the bunch. She's the oldest of the bunch, man.
You know what? When you have three holes and two hands, you can take on five guys.
And, man, that guy third in line is like, what, 62? 23 years younger than her.
Age is just a number.
Dude, she's getting busy, man. This is not the first time this old broad has taken a train of dudes. I guarantee you. This is not the first fucking time, man.
Doesn't sound like it.
No, it's five men and one 85-year-old woman. The story makes a point to say one 85-year-old woman. They are facing multiple charges, including breach of peace and public indecency. You know, at this point, what's the point? Why not just let them go with a slap on the wrist, so to speak?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm sure if she's doing that in the park at 85, she really doesn't give a shit about going to jail for a couple hours.
No. And, you know, I don't think she'll go to jail. I think she'll probably, they'll plead it down, you know, to, I don't know. I don't know what you could possibly plead that down to, but, you know.
Indecent exposure.
Cockfighting. I don't know.
Defecating in the park. I mean,
defecating in the park. They'll probably charge her with cockfighting and, you know, give her 1129, let her go.
Well, hey, Doug, you know, this has been, and of course, people listening to this won't understand this comment, but it's been a night of guests.
It has. We had a guest on, we do another podcast called Quick Hits that we co-host, and we had a guest from England, a buddy of ours. Absolutely.
Yes. Well, tonight, Doug, I'm surprising you with a guest.
Oh, man, who we got?
It is my lovely wife, Christy, and she has a story for you.
She has a BTFU story?
Yes. Let me transfer the headphones.
Back the fuck up. Hang on. Now guesting for Rob Clark, the lovely and talented Christy Clark.
What up, Doug?
What is going on, Miss Christy? Welcome. Say hi to Producer Grant. He's in the control room in there.
Hi, Producer Grant. How are you this evening?
He's good. He's giving the thumbs up through the glass there. Yeah.
Oh, through the glass. He's in the secret box, huh?
He's in the other room. Yes, ma'am. We are separated.
As opposed to my secret box.
I don't even know where to go with that one.
Just back the fuck up.
Back the fuck. Now you're making the long-haired guy uncomfortable.
That wasn't my intention.
I keep telling Rob I'm really a fucking prude at heart, but he doesn't believe me.
I don't believe you either.
He doesn't listen.
Plays one on TV.
I play one on the radio, yes.
Exactly. Yes. So I have a great story for you and for all the female listeners out there.
Is it about Rob?
No, it's not about Rob.
Oh, man.
I mean, I can tell some stories about Rob if you want me to.
Well, hey, I'm always down for that. We can have it.
Which one do you want? You want both?
No. Whichever story. If you want to embarrass Rob or not, that's totally up to you. I mean, because, like, hey, I'm in Tennessee. You're the one got to live with him.
Right. You know? I have to get all the evil eyes for the next
time. Right. Yeah, I get to go home. You guys are kind of there after this is over with. So whatever. Yeah.
Very true. So
totally up to you.
Let's talk about the Vagina Museum that just opened in London.
Yes, the Vagina Museum. I did hear about this.
You
did. Doors opened wide.
Oh, yes. God.
Yeah, you did hear about it.
I heard about this. I certainly
did. You hear what it's dedicated to?
What it's dedicated to?
Right.
Vulvi. I would assume.
It's dedicated to ending the stigma surrounding vaginas.
Is there a stigma surrounding vaginas?
Apparently, this doctor, you're going to love the name, Skechter.
easy for you to say.
Right?
Yeah.
It's actually a she and her team want to dispel the good for good and never ever hear again the biggest vagina myths. So let me go over the top five really quickly.
Wait a minute. Are these myths? Before we do this, let's clarify this. You said the biggest vagina myths.
Correct.
Are these the most? Are these myths about big vaginas, or are they big myths about vaginas in general?
They're what she likes to call muffbusters.
Muff, but
yeah. Welcome to this episode of Muff Busters.
I could totally write that show. Totally.
She says that.
Hey, speaking of vaginas, Christy.
Yes.
Hillary Clinton is real old.
Yes.
Now you're supposed to go, how old is she?
Sorry, how old is she?
Her vagina has a separate entrance for blacks.
But I'm.
That's right. A Pentecostal preacher told Rob that joke one time.
Oh, really?
Yes, absolutely.
Is that a story another day?
You've never met the Reverend Hyundai. We got to introduce her to the Reverend Hyundai one of these days, Rob. But I'm sorry.
And save her at some point.
Yes, yes. I'm sorry. I interrupted your vagina place. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Pray. Continue, madam.
So she says that vaginas and vulvas are basically the same thing. I disagree.
This is not what I have been led to believe. No, ma'am.
Right?
There's an outer and an inny.
Yes.
So let's just talk about that for a second, for those inquiring minds. The vulva is the external part of your genitals, consisting of the outer and inner labia, clitoris, and urethral opening. The vagina is the internal canal extending from the vulva to the cervix.
Yes. Those are two different, totally hold it.
Pokey holes.
Equally as mesmerizing and enjoyable, I might add.
So, vulvas are supposed to look a certain way. Just as faces can look vastly different, so can vulvas.
Well, yeah. I mean, you wouldn't expect any two to look exactly alike, right?
Very true.
That's true.
Might be a little bit confusing. Vaginas are messy and need cleaning.
Some may need it.
I feel like there's probably a lot out there that need it.
Yeah, I think so.
Hold this bottle of peroxide for a second.
Easy.
If you use a tampon, you're no longer a virgin. That's a long-standing myth that stems from the fact that to insert a tampon, a woman might tear her hymen.
I've never tried to insert one. I don't know.
I hope not.
No.
I mean, at some point, your wife might need help with that.
Yeah, we're like almost 50. You know what I'm saying? It's not an issue anymore.
Me either, thank goodness. Woo!
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever been happier in my life. No more babies. Yes! So the last one is vaginal discharge isn't normal.
And I tell you what, in certain situations can be quite upsetting and unexpected.
Very true. Very true. So those are the myths, and that's what the...
But they say that that's healthy, and like to douche is not healthy.
Right.
It's the way of cleaning itself.
The fact that you know this is frightening, babe.
Well, I read the article.
Well, yeah, he's right. Like months ago, I think.
Probably.
He's got Google alerts set up for just the word vagina, I think.
So let me just read this sentence because it just caught me.
Notice he didn't deny that.
Very true.
Very quiet in that moment.
He said true shit.
I'm just putting him right out there, getting him busted.
The only time you have to have concern is when there is a foul odor, it becomes itchy and thick, or it turns bloody or dark yellow to greenish. You have an infection.
Yeah, you got a bad infection.
Yeah, if you get to that point, you probably should just pass go and head straight to the ER.
This goes back to something that Rob and I have said on this podcast several times before when it pertains to this very issue, and it is this. This is our BTFU advice to everyone. We've actually done this before. Wash your ass. Jesus Christ, people. Right. Wash your ass.
I concur.
Wash your ass. It's very easy. Soap is cheap. I think that was a point that we made previous on this program.
Just get up in there.
Get up in there. Get a loofah if you have to. You can put
like lube might hurt a little bit. You know, it's a little bit rough.
You can put Dawn dishwashing liquid and water in a squirt gun. This can be done. We can do this.
That's very true.
Get clean.
Kind of like a Dawn enema.
Kind of, yeah. Yeah, but with feeling.
Right.
Hey, you know what? Speaking of which, I have a great story here.
Oh, I'm listening.
There is this this columnist. Every year he puts together a story about the most interesting things people have gotten lodged in their body cavities.
Oh, this is going to be good.
Over the years. Can Rob still hear us, by the way? Okay.
Yes, he can.
I want to read this story. It says, "We Americans as a people, are extremely good at shoving things inside ourselves." This is true. This is true. Now, here's a question I want to know. Lesbians, this is totally off subject. This just occurred to me because I was thinking about this the other day.
Squirrel.
Lesbians will turn their nose up at a penis.
But
plastic shaped like one, that's a whole different fucking story.
Right.
Well, it's not attached to the asshole man.
is that
women
what it
are
is?
Assholes too?
No. I don't know any of those.
I do.
Not me. "For a decade," this guy writes, "I've been chronicling our country's cavity misadventures. And I've learned several things." Oh, and I apologize to whoever wrote this, whoever's been doing this for a decade. I totally cropped that part out. I forgot. I'm sorry, but it's a great article. It says, first thing, it's dangerous to be horny. The sheer number of sex toys removed in emergency rooms is too high to include on this list for the most part. Which is true, because my wife has told me stories of being an ER nurse. But anyway, it says here, guys, that second is that men are far, far, far stupider than women when it comes to estimating what will fit and what will not fit.
You don't say.
This is obvious, but it's nice to have the data to back it up.
Very true.
The third is that the human body is a wondrous thing, but the human imagination is even stronger. And he makes the point here that as Americans, we continue to lead and innovate. And lots of things, including the shit that we stick in our bodies that we shouldn't. Apparently, America, we've got a problem with this thing that the rest of the world just hasn't even gotten close to thinking of yet. Guys, now, these are things that provable by X-ray that men have had to have surgically removed from their penis in the year 2019 in America. You ready?
Wait, from their penis?
Penis. There's several categories here.
I thought you were going somewhere else with that.
Other places.
And then you said penis, and I got really concerned.
See? Ha! Threw you a curveball, didn't I? Uh-huh. Yeah.
All right, what can we shove in our penis?
Crayons.
Oh, my God.
A Sharpie marker cap.
Oh, Jesus. God.
A chopstick.
Whoa. Splinters.
Ballpoint pen.
Ouch.
A piece of toy pliers. You know, like the little Fisher-Price workbench set, you know, that you get your boy when he's three with got the little plastic pliers. Yeah.
Oh, so yeah. We got a pair downstairs.
Yeah. Hey, Christy.
What's Dave?
Christy.
What's Dave doing? He's yelling to his son, hey, bring up those tweezers.
Lollipop stick.
I
guess popsicle stick. I don't even understand this. A piece of coaxial cable.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
A wedding ring.
In your penis, not around it.
Quarter-inch magnets. No, that was in.
Oh, my.
In. A screwdriver.
Fuck.
Okay. Here we go. The vajayjay.
This is going to be good.
A toothbrush.
Oh, my fucking God.
A metal and plastic container.
What?
A roll of tape. Quote, was being arrested by the police, so she took her cell phone and hid it from them in her vagina. A perfume bottle. Makeup sponge. A pair of underwear. Now, that I can kind of see. I can see where that would happen. You know. Maybe maybe it's huge and you get in a hurry. You know, I don't know. I don't know. But a G.I. Joe action figure.
Wow.
A rubber super ball.
Oh, my God.
And, quote, from the medical report, jumped off couch, landed on spoon.
Yeah.
Now, this is a good.
Naked.
Naked. Right. Naked. Yeah. Naked. Yeah. Okay. This is a good. This is rectum. Here we go. Patient states that he slipped in the shower and landed on a metal air freshener can.
In the shower.
And it went into a folded pocket knife.
Oh.
Yeah. Plastic lightsaber about 6 inches long.
Jesus.
Toothpick. Toothbrush. Toothbrush holder.
Oh, my God.
Plunger handle.
Oh. How many of these guys were in jail?
They're all in the bathroom. It's like all these dudes are in the bathroom, and they realize, you know what? I really want to stick something up my ass. What's handy?
What's going to be the least painful?
Probably the next item, a piece of mattress foam. Yes.
Oh, my God. Maybe they had diarrhea.
Maybe. Two small vibrators. Three small vibrators. This is the list. Two small vibrators. Three small vibrators. Two large vibrators. One very large vibrator.
Jesus.
A condom wrapper. Coat hanger. Patient unsure how it got there.
You see what happened was.
He must have passed out at a party.
What happened was. A garden hose nozzle, cigarette lighter, toy hockey stick, entire water gun, bag of heroin, $7 in coins.
Oh, my God.
A roll of quarters.
Wait. What's that sound like walking down the street?
He lost $3 up in his stomach somewhere.
An egg timer. An egg timer? Fucking egg timer? Back the fuck up. An egg timer? That's what it says. Small shampoo bottle, large shampoo bottle, jumbo shampoo bottle.
Well, Doug, you know an egg timer is shaped like an egg. So maybe they were
playing chicken.
Yeah. How did the chicken cross the road?
Ah, man, I don't know. You know, my wife told me a story similar to this. She was she was an ER nurse right after we got married. And this guy comes in and his wife brought him, right? And she described it as 11 inches long, but it was like gone. The vibrator up this dude's ass. It was just gone. Like they couldn't retrieve it, right? Mm. And so they put the guy out and they go to do the surgery to get it. And she said the funny part was everybody was all serious. It's like 2 a.m., you know, it's like emergency surgery and shit. And, and the doctor's tool that he had in the ass to retrieve it, it moved the base to the right and cut it on in the middle of surgery. So this thing just fired up in high gear, she said. And this guy's like out, you know, with the anesthetic.
Ass jiggling all around.
Yeah, yeah, for real. But she said that, like, they cleaned it up and put it in a box and tried to give it back to the wife. Like, hey, you want this back? And she says, no, I don't want it back. Keep it. So if that was her attitude, that tells me, if she's pissed off, she's not the one that put it there.
Probably not.
This was a surprise to her, and she was not happy about it.
How'd that conversation go, do you think?
Ah, man, that ride home. Oh, my God. Or the ride to the hospital. Can you imagine? How
probably ended in divorce.
Hey.
Right.
Should we tell Christy about the first story that I read, Rob? Ask her what she thinks about these people. Check this out. About the old people in the park?
Sure.
Yeah, yeah. This happened in Fairfield, Connecticut, Christy. Six Connecticut seniors were arrested after police say they caught the group allegedly having a sex orgy in a public park. They range between 62 and 85. The group of six seniors...
Oh my.
Consisted of five men and one 85-year-old woman.
Oh, my. You go, girl.
You, you go, girl. Hey, man, there's no moss growing on her ass.
No, there's no shame in her game.
Nah, her vulva's palpitating, by God.
Probably doesn't smell too great either.
It's got that greenish yellow thing you were talking about earlier. Oh, my goodness. So that, ladies and gentlemen,
this thing had to be dry as bone and probably dust flying out of it.
I don't know, man.
They probably needed one of the water bottles that was stuck to someone else's ass to keep her moist. Oh, I said the moist word.
You said the moist word, Christy. Dang.
I hate that word.
I got to admit, that was kind of cool.
I think a lot of these items, Doug, that you mentioned, found up in people's orifices.
Yeah.
Or say that again, babe.
Orifices.
Orify.
Should come with warning labels for idiots. You know, don't stick this in your ass.
Don't stick this in
your
ass.
Don't stick this in your pee hole.
Dude.
Did you really just say pee hole?
He says that a lot on this fucking podcast, and I don't know why. Yes.
It's your pee hole, but you can't. There's no other hole.
It's my asshole.
Not in your penis. It's a penis hole.
Yeah, Rob. What the fuck kind of freak show you got going on down there? You got.
But look, check this out, Doug. In Japan, the Japanese are weird ass people. And first, thank Christy for her guest appearance on
the show. Thank you for you. She should do that more often. She should drop in and say hi.
Hi.
You know, we need a regular segment on the show called The Christy Chronicles, where she comes on and just does a quick, like a 5-10 minute thing of like an embarrassing life with Rob situation.
Oh, I can work on that.
The Clark Chronicles.
There you go.
Like
that's a never ending saga.
He's typing me a text right now. Shut the fuck up. What are you doing?
No, he's not.
I would.
Well, hey, Doug, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Hey, anytime, Miss Christy. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And please tell my Hillary Clinton vagina joke tomorrow to somebody.
I will, absolutely. Right.
Cool, cool.
Bye, Grant.
He says bye.
All right, so speaking of warning signs, Doug.
Warning signs.
Yes. People in Japan have formulated the ultimate warning sign. And they're making women wear it on their clothes.
What is it a warning of?
It is a warning so other people know when they are on their period.
Well, why would that be anybody's business?
Well, you know how women can be on their period. As I distance myself from getting smacked by Christy here.
Oh, you mean just like meaner than shit? It's not like a biological thing. It's a psychological thing.
No idea.
So it's not like to warn you. It's not like warning, I am menstruating. It's more like warning, physically, like warning.
It's a physical warning.
But it's like warning, you are apt to get the fuck slapped out of you, basically.
Yes. Just use extra caution when speaking to me, apparently. Period badges for female workers at a Japanese company are criticized. The badges feature a cartoon character called Siri Chan, known for being a symbol of women's menstrual health in Japan. And what it looks like?
Yeah.
I don't know if you've ever seen the giant red monster from Bugs Bunny cartoon.
Yeah, the big fucking furball thing. The space monster. It chased the little Martian guy around and shit on the up on the planet.
That's what he looks like.
So, it's a big red.
They have to wear it under their name badge if they're on their period.
So basically, a big red sponge.
Yeah.
Oh, that's kind of nasty.
A Japanese department store has come under fire for asking its female employees to wear badges, letting people know they are on their period. Staff working at Michikaki store in Osaka, Japan, which is known for selling products related to female sexual and menstrual health, have been asked to wear a badge with a little cartoon called Siri Chan a name loosely translated as Miss Period. The badges, which are not compulsory, apparently they don't make them, were introduced by executives to encourage staff and customers to bond at the store to tackle the ongoing stigma around periods. And at the store, they have a giant life-size cartoon character of Siri Chan. I guess there's somebody in a big period-looking suit that walks around the store. And they have stuffed animal toys of Siri Chan that you can buy as well. However, an executive has revealed that the plan has received many complaints from the public, adding, some of them are concerned about harassment, and that was definitely not our intention. The unnamed male executive added that the company was now rethinking the badge idea and never intended to make it compulsory. So... Huh. Michikaki is a shop split into four sections which correspond to different stages of the menstrual cycle based on an app which co-launched the store.
Based on an app?
The Japanese are so far ahead of us, dude.
Well, apparently. I'm still trying to wrap my head around that.
In Japan, store manager Takahiro Imazu said, ooh, there is a tendency...
Easy for you to say.
Yeah, there's a tendency for women's sexuality and periods to be subjects not to be mentioned. Not all customers will react positively, but the femtech boom is growing and the values of young people are changing with it. So, yeah, it's just basically a store in Japan is asking their employees to wear a period badge when they are on their period.
Well, now, I'll say this about that. I don't have to worry about that. So, you know, whatever's up with Japan, you guys do your thing. You know, it doesn't bother me.
Yeah, they've always been on the fringe of sexuality, weird sexuality, I guess you would call it. You know, they have those crazy game shows, you know, where, you know, well, you've seen them, I'm sure. And if you haven't,
oh yeah, yeah,
Google Japanese sexual game show, and you will find many. You're welcome.
Many, many, really. I'm not too familiar. I don't think.
Oh, yeah, like they'll line up like a bunch of dudes, and he has to guess if his girlfriend is the one sucking his dick. Like he'll have all these other chicks suck his dick, and his girlfriend. And he has to pick his girlfriend, you know, and then he wins a prize.
So actually, the girlfriend is in, so it's like you get a blowjob from five different chicks. You have to guess which one's your girlfriend.
Right, right.
And the downside to this game show is,
I guess if you pick wrong, you don't have a girlfriend anymore, but you got five blowjobs.
Well, yeah, let's think about that. I mean, you know, if you pick wrong, I think it was number three and it's number five and your girlfriend gets mad and storms off and she's pissed off. Number three's kind of still there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ask for that number three phone number, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Which dojo you be in, you know.
That's right.
I don't, okay, I'm still trying to think of downsides, Rob, honestly. I don't know.
They are way more advanced than we are when it comes to sexual openness in their society.
Well, you know, we are not very open. We are quite judgmental in this country. What if I get to, like, speaking of which, and I think this lady is being persecuted, and I think it's wrong. I want to tell you about this lady. Rob, she is a Kentucky family court judge. Have you heard this story about this Kentucky family court judge
who's being
persecuted because of her sexuality? A Kentucky judge, a Republican Kentucky judge, was suspended with pay pending investigation into accusations of misconduct, including, among others, nepotism, retaliation against local government employees, and having an affair, a threesome, with a man and a woman in a courthouse office.
Well, I'm waiting for the downside.
Again, and you know what, dude? She doesn't look too bad. She's a blonde chick, you know. She's probably around our age. says, in addition to the alleged affairs, what was her name? Dawn Gentry was suspended Monday after she was charged with 9 counts of misconduct. But that's one of the things they charged her with. Apparently, that's is that a crime, having a threesome in an office?
Maybe she was on the clock or on the cock.
Maybe. You know, Nashville.
She was on the cock on the clock.
Well, you know, that happened to Nashville's mayor. Our mayor here in Nashville a couple years ago. We had a MILF of a mayor. Maybe, what do you call it? Yeah, one of those, Rob. She was an older lady, when you know. But anyway, our mayor, Megan Berry, was her name. And she was having an affair with an assistant police chief or some damn thing on her security detail or something, or a guy that worked for the state troopers, and they were flying all over the fucking country on all over the world, taking trips to Greece and shit
on the taxpayer's
dime, man. And this cat was fucking, like, the overtime he got paid, I forget, it was something ridiculous, something absolutely fucking stupid, you know, her boyfriend. He was getting like 80 hours overtime a week or some shit, and always with her. And turns out, dude, there's like this old historic cemetery in Nashville, you know. It kind of reminds you of some of those cemeteries in New Orleans, you know, with the big mausoleums and the big sort of monuments and shit like that.
Yeah.
And they were meeting there in the morning and having a little bang session in an SUV before they would ever go to work. And then they would fly here and fly there. But, dude, that shit came out, and it wasn't 2 days, man. They just, bam, they arrested the guy, and they arrested her for, you know, all kinds of fraud and cheating the system and all that stuff. And
ain't nobody watching but the ghosts.
Man, dude. Oh, no. Apparently, the local NBC news affiliate was watching close, because they had all kinds of footage and shit of this chick going in and out of the cemetery. And, man, bless her heart. I don't know what she's up to now, but she's not running no damn city governments, I'll say that. But, yeah, I mean, this judge in Kentucky, if she's really, you know, if she's doing all this other malfeasance, you know, messing with the money and all that, yeah, but don't run her out of town just because, you know, she's got a little different taste than the rest of you. You know what I'm saying? Hell. That's discrimination.
That is.
Yeah, man. Kind of admire the girl, you know. It's like you said, that's taking on a hell of a workload.
And then, no doubt.
Fucking A. And to have the confidence to pull it off, bless her heart. Still not as impressive as the 85-year-old chick.
No. True shit. And speaking of big workloads, Doug.
Uh-huh.
Speaking
of big workloads.
From Pink News. .co.uk. We are asked a question, and I will pose this question to you to see if you know. Who has the biggest penis in the world?
How the hell should I know? The only thing I'm absolutely certain of is one motherfucker that don't, and that's me. That's the only fucking thing I know for sure.
Well, do me a favor while I'm reading this story.
I'm not measuring my penis.
No. Just Google the name Jonah Falcon.
I don't want to. Am I going to see a big old giant dick? Is that what you're doing to me?
Jonah Falcon still holds the record for the biggest penis in the world, but rival Roberto Esquivel Cabrera remains convinced.
Jonah what? Jonah Hill?
Falcon. Yeah, but Roberto Esquivel Cabrera remains convinced that he should have the title.
Okay. American Falcon. Actor, it says.
Yes, who was
He came to national attention in 1999 over the size of his penis, 13.5 inches long when erect.
Yes.
However, Falcon has not authorized nor permitted independent verification of this figure.
That's correct. It apparently is 9.5 inches when flaccid. I believe that is the first time this word has ever been used on this podcast. Flaccid. It's just as bad as moist. His manhood, Jonah Falcons, has helped embed various A-list celebrities, including Oscar winners and porn stars. I wish they'd named the Oscar winners.
Okay, now I'm looking at a picture of this goofball.
Yes.
He looks like...
He looks like a fucking goofball.
He looks like... I don't know. He doesn't... Not what I was expecting with the big giant wiener, you know.
Yeah. Have you seen a picture of him in, like, spandex shorts?
Yeah, that's what, unfortunately, okay. goddammit, that's what I fucking saw.
Okay, well, this
looked
other
like
guy...
It looked like that motherfucker was smuggling a Christmas ham.
Yes.
Holy shit.
Falcons
record. What the hell do you do with that thing, man?
I don't know.
Where do you put that?
I don't know.
His lower back's got to be fucked up. That's all I'm saying. His center of gravity's got to be... I bet that motherfucker falls over a lot because his center of gravity's not right, man.
Well, there's a guy, Roberto Esquivel Cabrera, right?
Yeah.
A rival to Jonah Falcon's title. He believed the Mexican man claims he actually has the biggest penis in the world, and he claims his penis is allegedly 18.9 inches. Cabrera claimed its extraordinary length has left him plagued with medical issues resulting from him not
that's
being
able... That's a fucking leg is what the fuck that is. That's like a deformation. That's like a third leg that didn't grow all the
Boy,
way.
It definitely is not a pretty sight. However, radiologist Dr. Jesus Pablo Guillermo, who has examined Cabrera, has thrown the record claim into question. When he came here to do a CT scan, my first impression was that it was a unique and unusual case. I had never seen a penis like Roberto's.
Dude, I just saw a picture of this guy, like, just standing, wearing pants. It's literally at his fucking kneecap.
Yeah.
It's literally at his kneecap, man.
What the CT scan showed was that there is a very large foreskin. It goes just below the knee.
Very large? That's a fucking understatement.
And they have an X-ray picture of this dude's wiener.
Oh, my God.
It looks like, okay, you remember those socks we used to wear in the 70s? Those real tall athletic socks?
With the fucking red stripe, with the three stripes
yes.
on top?
Yes.
Yes, yes. And don't, God forbid, you let the motherfuckers fall down. Even if they come up over your damn kneecaps. That's what we did, because we didn't know any fucking better.
Imagine putting a tennis ball down into this sock all the way to the toe.
I was going to say, it looks like a grapefruit in a tube sock, I bet.
And then putting the sock around your dick, and this is what this guy's dick looks like.
I bet, you know what? There's a saying we have here in Tennessee. It's called, when you get the cabbage disease. That dude's got the cabbage disease. You know what that means? That means the stalk won't hold up the head.
Right.
Yeah.
It's said that Cabrera has even used weights to stretch his manhood. And due to all the technicalities, the Guinness Book of World Records won't name Cabrera, meaning that in 2019, Jonah Falcon's Guinness Book of World Records as the biggest penis remains.
Dude, just judging by the pictures I've seen, I think that the Mexican dude's getting the shaft, so to speak.
I
mean,
I think so too.
No pun intended. But no. Really, man, this fucking guy's he's packing a what the fuck goddamn traffic cone in his fucking pants is what I saw.
You could literally slap somebody in the face with that. Just
dude, you could drive a fucking fence post with that.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Iron Man.
Yo, summertime, hole in the nine. Split the Vega in half. Jeeps rumble and my dogs puff. Grass bank stopping high. Xerox hydraulic. The kid with the most knowledge will obtain the touch top dollars. Hold me down, hand me my cape. Dusty bake, activate. Fuck your corny debates. I'm like cake or maybe like $10,000 rabbits. The kid wore through, switch up his accent. Now I'm from Paris. Cash the bill, frozen elements of gold. Signs from the most side causes me to break the mold. How the fuck was I? Niggas thinking, you think I fell off the ledge? The legendary ghost Dini might be dead.
Never impossible. Pull out black burners like tonsils. Two gallons hidden if we got to. Busting at y'all niggas daily. Wall of war hawking. Sucking your teeth cause God chain talking like ghost face this, ghost face that. Ghost so crack. Now with revelation spoken through rap. Velour down like the Sheik of Iran. Gasoline cream wrapped in hospital bands. Model vans, Michael Davis. It's me against housing. Extraordinary pro black. So God creation, shoot control thousand. Catch me at the flakes. Apollo, rap, Frederick Douglass. You know what? Hey yo, fuck this. Hey yo, how can I move the crowd? First of all, ain't no mistakes allowed. Here's the instructions. Put it together. It's simple, ain't it? Well, quite clever. Marvin, 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 you were a friend of mine. You stood for something. Tupac, Biggie, oh, how we miss you so. We want y'all both to know we really love you so. Ayo, Gucci down, Wally Boo, Jamaican hat long for a pound. Ask niggas how I get down. Don't speak much, deluxe plus imaginations holding no. Like Willie Hutch, you might have bumped into me on a Rikers bus. Weed in my cheeks, gem in my beauty sleeve. That's serious, knowledge by 2%. Triple geese, come on, we jungle Mike Street, call Molly Amps. Advance to the final, show these niggas how the way we dance. Hot night, Jamaica, came through in a booger green. 68 pacer, mad paper high as a fuck. Truck, two rappers got stuck that night. I ain't saying no names, they know who. Thank you for the change, outdoor event. New Year's Eve, Cali weed, 30 seconds till weed tears the seas. Quick call my seeds, dipped in the crowd. The host spotted me, he knew not to call my name out. He walked off softly, we exactly formed like Christ and his disciples. Black fatigues, lethal face Dooney. He held the rifle, we had the whole shit shook. Your favorite rappers dropping they drinks. On the low, tucking they links. We made 80 off the books.
Magic Johnson. No disrespect, but metaphors to keep me out the project. Rap connect to keep me correct. Ayo, I wrote this on Donnie Roof after his funeral on one knee. Thinking his killers follow me, so tell my nigga Donnie. Up there, can you please tell God that we fucked up here? You got beer, weed, guns, AIDS. All these obstacles, it's hard to make it nowadays. Why's the devil winning? Some say it's our fault. If that's the answer, you know. Smokey cause cancer, let me drop a bracelet. Leave a chain behind my tape. Stay at the beginning, cause that's how they rewind. Y'all know how we dine. We don't eat swine, and we don't drink wine. If you don't bring me some motherfucking cognac, I'll kill you. I can't feel you. Ain't in my senses, and you ain't in my dollars. I fuck with rock wallets. No leashes, no collars. Rollick scholars, that's ghosting.